Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December 4th of 2021, well, it is titled Iridescent by Moonlight. So what do we see here? Well, here's an image taken last month, actually very close to the time of the lunar eclipse that we saw, and we see the full moon. Now, the full moon is when a lunar eclipse occurs, and that's because the moon, full moon, is directly opposite to the sun in the sky, and that's the only time it will pass through Earth's shadow, which of course is also directly opposite to the sun in the sky. Now, in this case, we are not looking at the eclipse itself, at least not the eclipse as moon passes into Earth's shadow, but as the moon passes through behind a cloud. So moonlight is coming through a cloud, and it's a very thin cloud up high in the atmosphere, and some various tiny water droplets will diffract or bend the light, and that will depend, bending will depend on the wavelengths of the light, and you get this iridescent pattern illuminating the cloud. Much as you can see a similar effect with oil on water, where you'll get all sorts of different levels of color there. You'll get the whole colors. And here we get a similar effect in the clouds because of the moonlight as it passes through. Now, it takes something relatively bright like the moon to be able to do this. We wouldn't notice it with the starlight, as they would not be sufficiently bright. Now, we can also see a group of stars here. You see a number of stars scattered around, but off to the lower left, just within the clouds there, you'll see a grouping of stars. And in fact, this is what is called the Seven Sisters or Pleiades star cluster. It's an example of an open star cluster, and the moon happened to be relatively close to that at the time of the eclipse. So here we are, not quite at the eclipse, but we're still in the same portion of the sky in the constellation of Taurus, and that's where the Pleiades happens to be located. Now, an open cluster is a cluster that is not gravitationally bound together. So over tens and hundreds of millions of years, they will eventually spread out and not be a cluster anymore. So many stars, such as our own sun, were likely part of a cluster like this at some point when they originally formed billions of years ago, but have drifted off. Now, other clusters can be gravitationally bound together, and their stars stay with them for their entire lives. But other stars slowly move away and just continue to orbit through the galaxy, so they're bound to the galaxy, just not to their own individual cluster, and the Pleiades would be an example of that. So that was our picture of the day for December 4th of 2021. It was titled Iridescent by Moonlight. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Comet by Eye. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.